Hello, I'm Dr. David Alleman. I've been practicing dentistry for 44 years and practicing biomimetic restorative dentistry for 27 years. This is new to many dentists, but the main concepts that we want to talk about in this short video are deep margin elevation, biologic width violation, biomimetic restorative dentistry techniques, and dental research. So we'll be talking about these on numerous YouTube videos, and hopefully you find a way to understand that there is a new way to do dentistry. And this dentistry has the ability to keep a tooth bonded together, side to side, front to back, and top to bottom in a way that traditional adhesive dentistry can't do. And of course, adhesive dentistry tries to bond a tooth together, but it has problems, and that's why most dentists don't have the confidence in adhesive dental techniques, because they feel like their crowns last longer. Well, you don't have to be a dentist for very long to have a few failures of your crowns or other people's crowns to know that in 5 years, a percentage of crowns will fail. The reason they fail is they're not connected side to side, front to back, and top to bottom. The crown sits on the remaining tooth structure, but when the crown moves, the tooth structure doesn't. So that creates a gap underneath the crown or underneath the filling, and it's not like a natural tooth. We have a piece of dental research, an important piece of dental research that was published actually over 10 years ago. It was published by a group of German dentists, Frese, Wolf, and Stale, and it says proximal box elevation with resin composite and the dogma of biologic width, clinical R2 technique, and critical review. It's a very well-done piece of scientific research, meaning that when you look into the references, it will contain 29 references that they're basing their questions on and basing their research and giving new answers to many of the traditional questions of why restorations fail, particularly subgingival restorations. And so the biologic width is traditionally thought of as a 3 millimeter attachment of the tooth from the soft tissue. The soft tissue is divided into three parts. We have a sulcus depth, and then we have an attachment that is an epithelial attachment, which is not as strong as the lower attachment, which is called a connective tissue attachment. The difference in histology is that we have blood vessels in the connective tissue. We don't have blood vessels connecting to the tooth in the epithelial attachment, and of course, no attachment in the sulcus. But this biologic width that gets inflamed from traditional dentistry is shown by this paper to become inflamed because there is a biofilm present underneath crowns and fillings. And the connective tissue is responding immunologically to the bacteria, not to the filling material or the crown material. And so once you understand that, the solution to that problem is to keep the bond of the restoration to the tooth structure less than the size of a bacteria, which is 1 to 3 microns. So in a biomimetic protocol, you have the ability to establish a bond to dentin on the 100 to 200 nanometer scale. So a nanometer is 1,000 times less than a micron. So if you have a connection of your restorative material to the tooth that's 1/5 the size of a small bacteria, then water molecules might be able to pass in there, dye molecules might be able to pass in there, but a bacteria cannot get into a gap that's 100 to 200 nanometers. The gap is too small. So that's the foundational principle, and that's how we understand the difference between biologic width violation and biologic width inflammation from an unsealed restoration. That's our message today, and we hope to see you next time. We'll make some connecting links to some of the podcasts that we've made in the past 3 years. If you want to learn more about my training programs, you will find my upcoming in-person and online programs linked in this video description. Until next time, get bonded and stay bonded.